Now, the implementation of the country's first sovereign wealth fund put on hold by none other than President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Speculations as to why are swirling, but one lawmaker says the president's move shouldn't be overanalyzed. Pia Gutierrez with the full story.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. applying the brakes on the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund. Marcos has ordered the suspension of the MIF as he sought a further study on its implementing rules and regulations. Malacanang says this will ensure the purpose of the fund will be for the country's development, with safeguards in place for transparency and accountability. Critics have warned the fund may add to the country's already huge debt burden and crowd out funds for key government programs. The suspension was welcomed by lawmakers. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, who led the filing of a Supreme Court petition against the fund's law, says the measure has a lot of defects, and it's no wonder why the law is not ready for implementation. Other lawmakers say the suspension is an opportunity to address the law's weaknesses when it comes to the mandatory contribution of government banks.
Sa kasong ito, minandato ng batas na sila'y mag-contribute. Kaya pinaglalaban ko sana na dapat may mandatory minimum profit at guaranteed profit yung mga bankong ito na hindi nakapasa sa period of amendments.
Even Deputy House Speaker Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo, who was part of the House majority that approved the MIF law last year, supports the President's decision.
I'm not a member of the economic team. So therefore, as a member of Congress, what I want to say again is to repeat that the president must have his reasons, and we trust his instincts on this. And I think we have nothing to lose if we support the president in the suspension as he deems appropriate.
A former official of the Philippine Central Bank says with the suspension of the law, contributions of the two state-led banks should be returned by government.
And in the first place, yung pera ng land bank at saka ng DBP is not exactly owned by the government. Depository yan ng publiko.
The Development Bank of the Philippines says it will strictly abide with the president's directive, while the land bank says it has received the instruction and will await further details. The DBP had already contributed 25 billion pesos to the MIF, while the land bank remitted 50 billion pesos as mandated by law. Gunigunde suspects that the suspension may have been rooted in the request of the two government financial institutions for regulatory relief from the central bank.
It is possible that these two GFIs are still compliant with the BSP requirements of 10% capital adequacy ratio. But because of their commitment to the MIF, bababa yung kanilang kapital, and unless bigyan sila ng BSP ng regulatory relief, hindi sila makakapagpautang o bababa yung kanilang pagpapautang. The second possibility is they may no longer be compliant with the BSP requirements, and therefore, there is an urgency for the BSP to grant them regulatory relief.
But for a University of the Philippines economist, putting the implementation of the country's first sovereign wealth fund on hold will not look good to investors.
We're not yet a darling of investors, contrary to what the government is saying. And I think this backtracking when it comes to Maharlika puts a very big cloud of doubt on the ability of the Marcos administration to pursue reforms and improve the business climate of the Philippines.
Meanwhile, House Ways and Means Committee Chair Joey Salceda said the public should not overthink President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s order.
In simple language, the IR appears to have limited the president's option only to those who have submitted an application.
Congressman,
I think the IR will be tweaked. I think it can easily be done. It won't take much of a time.
Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno had earlier said the Maharlika Investment Corporation, which will manage the fund, is expected to be operational before the year ends. Meanwhile, the Solicitor General says state lawyers are still preparing to defend the Maharlika law before the Supreme Court in response to a petition questioning the law's constitutionality. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
Here are other corporate headlines. Bosch Philippines partners with the Ayala Group's AC Motors to create a new venture, Bosch Car Service. These are one-stop shop service outlets which will offer mechanical repairs, comfort upgrades, and other services and diagnostics. The two aim to open 20 Bosch car service outlets by 2024 and 60 within the next 5 years. Meanwhile, the Board of Far Eastern University, or FEU, authorizes the school to enter into an agreement with Unilab's MGHI Holdings. According to the deal, both FEU and MGHI will invest 300 million pesos each in Higher Academia Incorporated. HAI will then purchase the assets of Colegio de Sebastian Pampanga, a secondary and tertiary school in San Fernando, Pampanga. And finally, IKEA's total sales in the Philippines hit 8.7 billion pesos based on its financial report as of August 31st. That's up 28.3% spike from last year. Its franchisee and operator Ikano Retail adds 17 million of the 118.4 million visits to IKEA websites across its markets came from the Philippines. IKEA in Pasay City is the world's largest IKEA store. Asian markets closed mixed on Wednesday despite upbeat economic data from China. The world's second largest economy posted a 4.9% growth in the third quarter of 2023, a stronger than expected figure compared to the 4.4% forecast of economists. It also reported September retail sales and industrial production numbers that beat estimates. The latest data revived hopes Beijing will be able to meet or exceed its 5% target growth for this year. The positive news, however, failed to push Chinese markets higher, with the Shanghai Composite closing 0.8% lower today and the Hang Seng by 0.5%. This is the Middle East turmoil and higher bond yields kept investors cautious. Some notable stock movements in the region: shares of Taiwanese conductor giant TSMC slumped 2% after the U.S. announced that it plans to ban the export of more advanced AI chips to China. Meanwhile, shares of Chinese EV maker BYD soared nearly 5% on Wednesday, following robust sales and a higher third-quarter profit forecast. Here at home, Philippine shares closed lower, with the main index shedding 0.2%. Stock analyst Harold Tan says traders now have the opportunity to buy at these levels.
We are performing better than the previous months, and our hopes of entering into a free bull market era for this year is still there, so long the index can maintain its stance above 6,200.